Hello students, this is Shapnam here. In one of my previous videos, I have spoken about the scientific tips to study and score good marks. Hope you have viewed it, and in case you have not viewed it, please do check it out as it would surely be helpful for you. Did you ever feel that you are studying for a lot of hours, putting in a lot of effort, but even then you're not scoring good marks? Or sometimes you study everything, but during the examination, you're not able to recall or retrieve what you have studied. If yes, that means the study method which you have been using so far is not the right method. So in today's video, I'm going to speak about one of the scientific method of study, which is known as the SQ3R or SQRRR method, which will not only help you to remember and recall whatever you have studied, but it will also help you to answer the question no matter from which corner of the chapter it has been asked, so that you can manage to get full marks and be one of the topper. I have personally suggested this method to a lot of students, not only school but also college going students, and have observed that it has really helped them to score very good marks. So let's get started. The SQ3R method has 5 steps. So S stands for survey, Q stands for question, and the first R stands for read, the second R for recite, and the third R stands for recall or retrieve. So the first step is survey. You need to survey the entire chapter. For this, you need to read the headings, subheadings, the introduction, the conclusion, as well as keenly observe each and every diagram in the chapter, charts or maps. By doing this, you would get a clear picture of what is present in that particular chapter. The second step is question. Based on what the teacher has explained in the class, or based on reading the heading and subheadings, you need to frame a lot of questions by yourself and try to answer that. Or you can make use of the questions which are given in the end of the chapter. So you will get an idea of how much knowledge you have in that particular chapter. For example, take that you are studying a biology chapter, that is plant and animal cell. So you can frame questions like, what are the difference between the plant and animal cell, or what are the functions of mitochondria? So you can just frame some questions and try answering the questions. The third step is to read. Read means you have to read from the first letter of the chapter till the last letter of the chapter. And while reading, always make it a habit to have a dictionary with you. And in case you don't understand the meaning of any word, you should immediately refer the dictionary and write down the easy meaning of that particular word. What is more important is you need to understand and read. And in case you find that you can't understand something or you have some doubt, just make a note of it, and the next day you can get it clarified from your teacher, friends or from your parents. The fourth step is recite. That is, you have to recite loudly. So what you do is you close the book and then you try to recite loudly all the important points or the summary of the chapter. See, by the end, at the end of the chapter, summary would be given. In some chapters, or points to remember would be given, which are the important points. So if you're not comfortable reciting it loudly, you can also take a sheet of paper and write the summary or the important points in the sheet of paper. The last step is to recall or retrieve. This you're going to do the next day. In my previous video, I have already mentioned that you need to prepare a timetable, right, and allot the days based on the subjects which you have. So for example, you have learned biology the previous day, and next day you're planning to learn chemistry or physics or the next chapter in biology. So don't directly jump into it. So what you have to do is that before you start with something new, you just try to recall or retrieve what you have learned the previous day. Just put some questions to yourself. But if you realize that you have forgotten something or you got stuck, immediately open the book, say the biology book, and try reading what you are not able to remember. So if you keep following this consistently this way, so what happens is that the information what you are studying would get stored in your long-term memory, and you will easily be able to recall or retrieve it during the examination. So this SQ3R method is one of the best scientific method which not only school students but college students have also adapted and found to be very useful. Initially, if you start something, it will be a little difficult because you must have been using some other method to study. But if you start using this method consistently, you will get used to it, but start slow. So this is one method which will help you not only to score very high marks but also to become a topper in the class. So wish you all the very best. In case you like my video, please do subscribe to my channel, The Counseling Corner, as well as hit the bell icon so that you get timely notifications whenever I post my new video.